Now here we have created the activate event output function, and this function allows us to activate the specified output on any my custom event node that is in the Kismet graph. The only problem with this function right now is that it's never actually called. I mean, we have nothing that ever actually invokes this function. And as a result, the output nodes of our custom event will never be called either. So we want to address this. In particular, we want to have two Unreal Console commands, startAnim and endAnim. And whenever I type in startAnim, I want to invoke the play output socket of my custom event. And whenever I type the command endAnim, I want to activate the stop output socket. So the question really here is, how can we do that? How can we create commands that we can type into the Unreal console that calls behavior in Unreal script? How can we associate Unreal console commands with particular functions? The answer to that question is that we can use what are known as exec functions. So I want to create two exec functions. Exec functions are functions that can be called by name from the Unreal console. I'm going to create one exec function for startAnim and one exec function for endAnim. So let's return to the code editor. I'm going to type exec function startAnim. Going to put the open and closing braces in here. I'm going to, startAnim there needs two. Okay, I'm going to add another function, endAnim. And here we have created two exec functions. Of course, these functions at the moment do nothing, but we can fix that. The startAnim command, when we type startAnim on the Unreal console, we want that to call the play output socket of the custom event node. So we want to call activate event output 0. And the endAnim function, when we call that from the Unreal console, we want to call activate event output 1, since 1 is associated with the stop connection of the Kismet event. So here we've created two exec functions, startAnim and endAnim. When we type startAnim in the Unreal console, it will call the startAnim function. When we type endAnim at the Unreal console, it will call the endAnim function. So what I'm going to do now is compile all of this code and return to the UDK editor. And really, we're going to test this out and see that it all works together. We're now back in the UDK editor, back in our level here. And before I give this a test run, I want to draw your attention to a few features. First, if I click View from the file menu here, View World Properties, I want to make sure that the game type for PIE under game type here is set to My Custom Game Info. This allows you to choose the game info class that is associated with the level. It is important to choose My Custom Game Info because this class contains the exec functions that we defined, and it also contains our activate game event function. If we choose some other game info class, then those functions will not be available to us because a different game info class will be instantiated by the UDK. So we want to choose My Custom Game Info. The next feature that I want to show you, if I click on the K icon to bring up the Kismet editor, I just want to show you the layout here that I've used for my Kismet setup. I have the matinee animation and I have the My Custom Event. You'll notice in the properties for my custom event, I have set max trigger count to 0. It is important that you set it to 0 because this defines the total number of times that this custom event can be activated. If the number is 1 or 2, it means that there is a limit to the number of times that I can activate this event. A value of 0 will allow us to activate the event as many times as we want. If this were 1, for example, I would be able to type in the command start anim to start playing the animation, but I would not be able to type in the command end anim. That command would do nothing because the event had already been triggered once before. So ensure this is 0 so we can trigger the event any number of times. With those features pointed out, let's press the play button now and give our level a test. Here we are, we're playing in the level, and let's try our start anim command. I will press tab on the keyboard and type start anim and press return. And here our portal is spinning as intended. I will press tab again and press the type the end anim command to call our end anim exec function. Press enter and it calls that function and it stops playback of the animation. So in creating these classes and in associating them with this level, we have created this level here that can use exec functions and can activate Kismet events. You will find the complete files for this level and the Unreal Script classes available at the URL mentioned in the video notes. I hope you have found this tutorial informative. Thank you for watching.